the course of human history and will never be eclipsed. Y'all ain't talking to me. There is nothing that is more important than the fact that our God got up. I wish I had some help right there. That there is no other event that matches the magnitude of the fact that he got up with all power. Humankind, even now, bases its calendar on him. BC meaning before Christ, and AD meaning after his death. The worship calendar has changed from the Sabbath being on Saturday to the day that he arose from the grave, being the day that we come and worship. Before his resurrection, heaven was restricted to one people from one race of one vast experience. Now, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creation. Old things are passed away, and all things become new. And I've come this morning to argue that Jesus did not rise from the trappings of death, hell, and the grave, the sting of death, just so we can change the calendar. But he rose so he could do more than change a calendar. He came to change the world. And I'm not talking about the physical world. I'm talking about us. I wish I had some help right there. There's somebody here who thinks that the resurrection is just about Easter speeches and Easter eggs and Easter bonnets and Easter suits and Easter dresses and Easter hairdos and Easter shoes, but I'm talking about everything. You ought to have an appreciation for what God did for you on today. Do I got anybody here that's glad about the resurrection? The focus of our text deals with the core disciples shortly after the resurrection. The Bible suggests that when Jesus was arrested, tried, and sentenced to die on the cross, that all the disciples fled into yonder country. Y'all ain't saying nothing. But they have been confronted with testimonies of those that saw Jesus. Y'all ain't talking to me. My first point is, you won't be excited about the resurrection if you don't remember his promises. Yes. The disciples are given two different accounts of people who had seen him after the resurrection. The first is given by Mary Magdalene. Y'all know who she is. She was a woman that had been possessed with 7 demons. Y'all ain't saying nothing. In other words, she was perfectly possessed. She was possessed outside of her mind, and they couldn't trust the testimony of an ex-somebody. Y'all ain't saying that. But the truth be told, all of us in this room are an ex-something. Y'all ain't saying that. There's some ex-junkies in the room. There's some ex-alcoholics in the room. Everybody in here got a past. And the reason I can stand up now is because God delivered me from my past. Is there anybody in the room? I used to get twisted, but now God has picked me up, turned me around, and set my feet on solid ground. They didn't want to believe the testimony of Mary Magdalene, because they felt like she may have been given to exaggeration. But anybody know that God, when he has brought you out, you gotta stop.